We have 9 runners. Okay, horses coming out onto the track. Here's the 2 horse. This is Detroit. That's Alibaba del Sol, Mauro Manedudu from Italy. The first one that came out was Detroit. J.D. Petrovic, one of the top girls, one of the top riders around. She's as good as any man, better than quite a few, I can tell you. That's number 3, Plastin. This is the gray. Well, it's 2 grays, as you can see on the far side. That is number 4, Derham, ridden by Raymond Chang. A lot of the ladies like the gray horses. Let's check out the others as they canter down in this, what is now beautiful sunshine. Next one to come out in the black and white will be the other gray. Al Zane, bred in Great Britain. Here in the dark blue and orange, this is Tiduba. Angelina Batiste on board. Nice looking horse. Next one cantering down in front of us. The gray is Al Zane, ridden by Glenn Brame. And the one in the blue and yellow is Zam Zam, ridden by Marvin Suhrland from Germany. I call him marvelous. Marvin Suhrland, top-class jockey. And there's the other one that we haven't seen. That was Pandoro, another gray, Antonido on board. And that one there in the gray colors with the black star, that's Oosterlis, ridden by Toon van der Toost. So those are the starting stalls to which they'll be entering in the next couple of minutes for this race, over 1,800 meters. And one of the favorites here has got to be, let's just check out the latest news from the ring. Favorite here down in the ring is number 2, that's Detroit, ridden by J.D. Petrovic. Now this is the top girl. She won the big race at Longchamp last year. She's ridden over 75 winners, 28 years of age, and a top-class jockey, isn't she?
Absolutely. She's an absolute top-class jockey, and what you said before, she can have competition with every male jockey in the world. She is very good. Ik heb een oproep voor Beertje van Heiningen om even te komen in de rechterstoel. Beertje van Heiningen, rechterstoel, alsjeblieft. Start vrij.
The course commentary going out at the same time as us. Let's just check out some horses that I think I'm surprised. The 7 horse here, I thought Pandora would have a good chance, ridden by the Belgian jockey Anthony Doe, who's ridden over 600 winners. So they're now approaching the start for the first live race on Abu Dhabi TV. If you're tuning in Abu Dhabi or anywhere around the world on our website, this is Tomo. We're live in Holland. We're live just outside The Hague, and we're ready to load. They'll have over 1 circuit on ground that has been softened by the rain overnight. Good to soft. So here in the red and yellow, Pandoro, Anthony Doe, about to be led forward. Behind him in the blue with the yellow sash, that's another of the greys, Derham, ridden by Raymond Chang. Raymond, 4 times Dutch champion jockey. They're loading. Got a great crowd here as well today. It's expat day, so we've got visitors from all over the world. And they've got fashion displays, they've got car displays, plenty of horsepower here, and plenty of horsepower out on the track. So the horse is now loading up for the first live race we have for you. Stay with us. We've got some trotting to come. We've got some great Arabian racing to come. And it's all happening here in Holland. In the cross belt, in the quartered colors, that's number 3, Plastin, ridden by Martin Watlow. He's the next one to go in. Martin Duval is with me. Martin, how do you see this race going? Is there anything you think will be up there at the finish? The favorite at the moment, it's pretty close between numbers 2 and 6.
Number 2 is a very good horse, that is Detroit, trained locally here at Duindicht by Bianca van der Harst. Number 6, Al Zane, he is trained by Kim Augenbrue famous known Dutch female trainer. But the horse which I think is very interesting in this race is number 3, Plastin. Always finishes in the thereabouts and didn't quite manage this season to win a race, but I think he's knocking out the door.
Well, we'll soon find out if your predictions are right. We've got over half the field installed. One horse, by the way, just dismounted at the back in the cheek pieces. That's Detroit. J.D. Pastorvich just dismounted from that one. I think she might have just shot past the starting stalls. So I hope she's going to be going in, because Detroit is obviously one of the favorites here. Yeah, she's getting the leg back up. So we've got three out, three to go. Here in the back colors, just being loaded forward now, going into stall 8. That's number 6, Al Zane and Glenn Brame, the Belgian jockey. Ooh, getting a bit keen there. Now, Detroit in the cheek pieces is going to be the last of the 9 runners to be put in. Stand by, ladies and gentlemen, for the Wathpa Stud Farm Cup. This is coming live from Holland. It is local time, 2 o'clock. We're ready to race. They're off. Here we go, and it's a very good level break. Let's see who's going to take them along in the early stages. Pandoro on the far side. Here in the cheek pieces, Detroit. And Detroit, one of the fancied runners, is going to take them along. Up on the outside, Al Zane. Between the two greys, we've got in the black and white quarters. That's Plastin. Being forced quite wide is Albaba del Sol. Hugging the rails on the inside is Pandoro. Then the two in the blue and yellow colors. Dirham is the grey. Zam Zam is the darker horse. Then behind this one, we've got Osterlis. And the back marker at the moment is Tidublia. That's the order as they go down the far side. They've got about 6 furlongs left to run in this opener. And keeping out of trouble is number 2, Detroit. J.D. Petrovic, the top lady jockey here in the Netherlands, leads by 2. On the inside in the black and white is Plastin. Up on the outside is Al Zane. Then making a move on the far side is Alban de Sol. That's the one horse trying to get through on the inside. That is the grey, Dirham. Behind Dirham in the blue and the yellow sash is Zam Zam. And marvelous Marvin Suerland. Getting a reminder as they go towards the bend at the far end of the track is Austerlitz, and the back marker Tidublia has still got it all to do. Up front as they swing out of the back straight, they've got inside just half a mile left to run. And up on the outside, here comes Al Zane to challenge Detroit. Making a move on the outside is Albaba del Sol. Then comes the other grey, Plastin. And behind this in the red and yellow is Pandoro. The others are going to have to sprout wings to get involved. Into the home straight. Al Zane, Glenn Brame on board. On the right in the cheek pieces, that's Detroit. Then making a move towards the outside. Here comes Albaba del Sol. Right there as well in the black and white is Plastin. Trying to get through in the yellow sleeves is Pandoro. Here they come down towards the last furlong now. It's number 1, Albaba del Sol. And Mauro Manidu, the Italian-born jockey for the local girl, Karen van der Bos, has gone 3 clear. Inside the final furlong, it's Albaba del Sol. Here on the outside, Pandoro's putting in a good run. It's not over yet. There's still half a furlong left to run. Albaba del Sol, though, is looking good. Pandora's coming late, but ain't going to catch this one. Oh, on the line, it was close. But number 1, Albaba del Sol is the winner. Number 7, Pandoro, was the fast finishing second. And in third, that was number 6, Al Zane. So what a result for the Dutch trainer, Karen van der Bos, with Alibaba del Sol. The sun is shining here in Holland today on the local girl. Brilliantly ridden by Maru Manedu. And this is the very good Italian-born jockey. And he's given this horse a lovely ride, a very confident ride as well, because Pandoro, ridden by Anthony Doe, was staying on as well at the end. But let's take nothing away from this winner. This horse had it won from a long way out, despite being pushed wide at the first turn. And has really gone well on this good to soft ground. Here's a replay. They're well strung out. There's only one horse in it. And that is the Karen van der Bos trained Alibaba del Sol, the 8-year-old who's coming right away to win this in tremendous style. And has pulled off the hat trick here in real good style. The jockey took it very easy, and that means Pandora came late to get second. And in third place was Al Zane. But no doubt about the winner. That is number 1, Alibaba del Sol. And let's give this horse a great big cheer when he comes back into the winner's enclosure. Stay with us.
Dankjewel, Derek Thompson. Dames en heren, een belangrijke mededeling voor de bezitter, dan wel de chauffeur, van een tweetal automobielen. Allereerst de blauwe Citroën met het kenteken 43HGTG. De blauwe Citroën, kenteken 43, Hotel Golf, Tango Golf. Alsmede de eigenaar van de zilveren Jaguar S-Type met het kenteken 23PFGK. 23 PFGK. Beide auto's met spoed verplaatsen alstublieft. U verspert de doorgang.
And there is Karen van der Bos on the left in the purple trousers with the white top. Greeting her winner. She trains on the beach. She's a very deep thinking trainer. She really feels for horses. And not surprisingly, she's happy with that. A win on a big day like this means so much, especially when it's here in her native country. She won the Dali Award in America just 2 months ago for her services to Arabian racing. She really is a stalwart, but she's an innovator as well. And there's Lara Sawyer, just going to say well done. Lara, of course, representing the sponsors, Wattpa Stud Farm. And all the representatives who've come from our sponsors from Abu Dhabi, from around the world. And there, of course, you see the very familiar sight of the Emirates ladies, the Emirates stewardesses, who are the official carriers of this Sheikh Mansour Round the World Ladies World Championships, the Global Arabian Championships. We fly Emirates around the world, and these are the photos that will be going up. They'll be going around the Middle East at the moment. We're watching here on TV in Holland, and people around the world are watching, particularly in Abu Dhabi in the United Arab Emirates, and so much to look forward to.
Ladies and gentlemen, the provisional result. First number one, Alibaba del Sol. Second number seven, Pandoro. Third number six, El Sane. The fourth horse, number four, Darum. Voorlopige uitslag 1-7-6-4.
And very soon after the presentation, we'll be rejoining the Abu Dhabi sports presenter, the top presenter, Masood, who has flown in specially on Emirates to be here today, presenting this three-hour program live on Abu Dhabi Sports. Stay with us. And as we are in Holland, which is world famous for its flowers, a bouquet for the winner. Just up the road, by the way, one of the great auction houses where they auction the flowers virtually every day of the week that are sent around the world. Holland famous for many things, but certainly for its flowers. And it's lovely to see every winner receiving a bouquet of these beautiful flowers. So Lara Sawyer makes her way round to present the trophy for the Wattpa Stud Farm Cup. And our thanks to Wattpa Stud Farm for sponsoring the opening Arabian race. Still to come, Her Highness Sheikha Fatima Bint Mubarak Ladies World Championship. That'll be coming up in about 45 minutes. And after that, the Sheikh Zayed Bin Sultan Al Nayan Arabian Cup, featuring one of the best Arabian horses in the world, Poulain Cossack. So that's the scene in the winner's enclosure. And how nice to feel the warm sunshine after the rain overnight. I thought that was a great ride by the Italian-born Mauro Manuedu. He's now ridden over 750 winners worldwide. He's a great ambassador for Italy. And there in the middle is the great ambassador for Holland, Karen van der Bos, and the great ambassador for Abu Dhabi. And our thanks to the ambassadors who have come here today from their very busy schedule. And the trophy's sparkling in the sunshine here, where it's 2:10 in the afternoon in Holland.
Dames en heren, de uitslag van de tweede koers is officieel. Koers werd gewonnen door nummer 1 Alibaba del Sol. Tweede geplaatst nummer 7 Pandoro. Derde de 6 El Zane. Vierde de 4 Darum en vijfde de 3 Plastin. Zesde was de 8 Zamzam. 1, 7, 6, 4, 3, 8. De ren werd gemakkelijk gewonnen in de tijd van 2 minuut 8, 2 tiendes. Say that he said that he